Don't you know about me? Don't you know about me? Show you the power of the power. Pender for tonight's D1-1 district final. The winner of tonight's game will advance to play in the Nebraska School Activities Association State Basketball Tournament next week in Lexington. Tonight's game will feature the visitors of the Storm 1, the Sandy Creek Lady Cougars, and your hometown Pender Lady Cougars. We will begin tonight with the starters. From the visiting Sandy Creek, number 3, a 5'3" senior, Ella Martin. Number 5, a 5'8" junior, Riley Scott. Number 10, a 5'4" senior, Sophie Dane. Number 23, a 5'8" sophomore, James Hilltop. And number 32, a 5'8" sophomore, Emma Fisher. Sandy Creek is assisted by Kayla Anderson, Bill Pohlmeyer, Derek Shaw, and Becky Shaw. Head coach is Jared Blackwell.
Thank you.
School student body expects preparation, respect, integrity, determination, and excellence. Attendance at this event entitles you to enjoy an exhibition of skills developed by athletes in an educational setting. Please be respectful and encouraging in your approach to all athletes, officials, coaches, and fellow spectators. And now please rise if able for the singing of the national anthem sung by Pender High School student Ferris Swinton.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. For the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and home of the
Thank you. Thank you.
3 minutes left in the first quarter. C1, Cody Foley's got a quick 6-2. Again for the Lady Pendragons, number 0, Jake Greensmar. First personal foul on Ella Martin, the Cougars, checking in for Pender, number 1, Kyle Greensmar. First personal foul on Jim McPhee. In for the Lady Cougars, number 13, Madeline Anderson. First, a foul on Amy Wagner of Pender. And the pitcher is shooting for Zandy Creek. First, we throw on Fisher is good. First place of foul on Sophie Page of Sandy Creek. Second personal foul, offensive foul on Keller Martin of Sandy Creek. That's second team foul in the second quarter.
Thank you.
Third personal foul on Ella Martin of Sandy Creek, 13th foul. Checking in for Sandy Creek, number 13, Madeline Anderson. Second free throw by Maya Gallagher is good. First personal foul on Heavy Walsh of Pender. That is the second team foul. First personal foul on Madeline Anderson of Sandy Creek. That is a 15th foul. Time of first mark shooting. In for Sandy Creek is number 10, Sophie Gaines. Second free throw by Pender, first mark is good. Checking in is number for Pender, number 0, Jayla, three mark. Checking in for Sandy Creek, number 11, Paris Lepofsky. C1-6, Broken Coley's battle through 18-11. Leeds Clarkson leads 9-8. At halftime, Crofton leads Orr 24-22. Late in the second quarter, Dufferin Murdoch leads Ainsworth 23-21. With 4 minutes left in the second quarter, Cross County leads Superior 27-20. Late in the second quarter, Naya Barrett-Murray leads Bayer 23-19. In D1 at halftime, GACC leads South Platte 49-14. Also at halftime, Bethune Junction leads Alma 31-26. St. Mary's leads Summer Edgar Miller at halftime 26-23. Late in the second quarter, Johnson Broad beats Bancroft Rosalie 24-19. And week two at halftime, Fall City Sacred Heart leads Dunn County Stratton 29-8. After one quarter, Plainview leads Wilcox Hilliard 9-6. Late in the second quarter, Overton leads Lawrence Nelson 32-11. After one period of play, Why Not leads Crofton 20-10. At halftime, San Jose Bedford leads High Plains Community 29-18. Also at halftime, Shelby and Humphrey St. Francis 22-15. At halftime in C1, Broken Bow leads Battle Creek 23-18. They played in the first quarter, 6-1, Gothenburg leads Orchard Central 8-5. There's a halftime score. It's part of the game. He takes the 6-0 and back to the 14. Cross County is superior, 28-22. That is very important in these Bears, 23-19. At halftime, in New York, Johnson Brown, he's back up with 24. Pender's basketball to start the second half of play. First personal foul on Emma Fisher of Sandy Creek by a Dolliver shooting.
Thank you.
There's personal foul on Madeline Gulliver and Pender. That is a second team foul.
Thank you.
Third personal foul on
Thank you.
Personal foul on Madeline Anderson on Sandy Creek. Second personal foul. After the new comes in play, Pender 53, Sandy Creek 17. First of all, I'm going to go over a bit. Thank you. personal foul on Avery Wagner of Pender. Second team foul.
Thank you.
First personal foul on Private Monster Pender, 15 foul. Checking in for Sandy Creek, number 10, Sophie Dean, number 21, Lexi Shep. Free throw by Skalka is good. Checking in for Pender is number 14, Kaylee Schrader, and number 23, Lydia Melbourne. Checking in for Sandy Creek, number 35, Morgan Peter, number 25, Victor Colmeyer, number 51, Abby Sharp. Checking in for Sandy Creek. Number 50. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we have the presentation of the runner-up plaque to the Sandy Creek Lady Cougars. And now, to the D11 champions, and punching their ticket to the Nebraska School of Technical Association, D1 State Tournament, your Pender Lady Pendergast! Updates here. Midway to the third quarter, it's C1. It's Gallagher giving the Northwest Central 32-25. With 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter, Rattle Creek gets broken bow 44-43. And half, starting the second half, Sydney leads Blackwood 26-19. Midway to the first quarter in C2, Freeman leads Oakland Craig 5-3. Midway to the fourth quarter, Clark Community takes it to Kansas City at 13-30. Midway to the fourth quarter, Crofton leads Oregon 15-34. 3 minutes left in the fourth, Cross County beats Superior 42-35. 1 minute left in the fourth quarter, Elmer Burdock beats Ainsworth 49-45. 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter, here's a surprise. Nightmare Mercury leads Bayer 45-37. At halftime, UTAN beats Bayer Central 30-10. And at halftime, Bishop Newman leads Norfolk Catholic 28-16. D1 finals, TACC beats South Platte 78-38. With less than a minute in the fourth quarter, Johnson Crofton and Bancroft Rosalie are tied at 44. 7 minutes left in the fourth quarter, the Crofton's been tied at 48-45. 2 minutes left in the fourth quarter, St. Mary's in summer, they've been 27-32. Beginning the second half, Southern Valley leads Amherst 27-13. And at halftime, Elgin Public, Pope John leads Mayfield Hicks Center 28-16. In D2 at halftime, Hudson Sacred Heart leads Dunham County Strat 50-33. After 3 quarters, thank you. 34 to Rock Lock Center 24. Owens Edge beats Lawrence Nelson 63-19. And halftime, Sam Hess-Medford beats Lake Ridge Community 45-26. After 3 quarters, why not the Leeds Crawford 54-26? With a minute left in the fourth quarter, Humphrey St. Francis leads South 40-35. At halftime, Howells Dodge leads Murphy Christian 29-11. With a minute left in the fourth quarter, it is tied up between Broken Bow and Battle Creek at 44. It is now going into overtime between Pogimo and Battle Creek, tied at 44.
Thank you.